Sesame Street, and I'm looking for the word on the street. What's the word on the street?
Transform.
What do you think the word transform means?
Change into something else.
Have you ever seen anything transform?
A caterpillar turn into a butterfly.
An egg can turn into a chick.
Yeah. You totally transformed your face.
I did.
Keep listening for the word transform today on Sesame Street.
Transform.
That's the word on the street.
Excuse me, did you see Frank?
Just doing a little sweeping out here, keeping the grounds clean.
Hello, Chris.
Hello, guys. Hey, Rosita. Hey, Elmo. What's up, Telly? Let me guess. You guys are the Helpabots, and you're here to help me sweep, right?
Negative, Chris. We are not the Helpabot robots. Beep.
Oh, well, what kind of robots are you?
We are robots that transform. Beep, boop.
Transforming robots? Hey, cool. You know, I used to pretend that I was a robot that could transform when I was a kid. Wow, what do you transform into? A bumblebee? A car? Cassette tape player?
No, we transform into shapes. Beep, beep, beep.
Shapes? Now that's hot. Oh, wait, I'm going to pretend that I'm a robot that can transform into a shape. Ready? Okay, okay. Beep, boop, beep. I'm a circle. See? The circle.
That is not how we transform into shapes. That is so lame. Beep.
Okay. Well, then how do you transform into shapes?
Like this. Beep, boop. Transform. Transformation complete. Beep.
Oh, cool! Man, I wish I had a robot costume like this when I was a kid. And check it out. It gave you 1, 2, 3 sides and 1, 2, 3 angles. You are totally a triangle. Sweet!
Thank you, Beep. Transform.
Ooh, wow. What are you transforming robots call yourselves?
The Shapeabots, Beep.
The Shapeabots?
Yes. Come, Shapeabots, let's sing, Chris, the Shapeabots theme song, beep.
Shapeabots, we go any place. Shapeabots, we can change our shape.
Man, that's a catchy theme song. What now?
We wait for someone who needs a shape.
Wow, guys, I don't think anybody's gonna be needing a shape.
Help! Oh, I need a shape.
I stand corrected.
What kind of shape help do you need, citizen? Beep.
My name is Andy, and I lost my octagon.
Ooh, an octagon, beep.
Yes, an octagon, beep.
He needs an octagon, beep.
What's an octagon, boop?
Oh, an octagon is a shape with 8 sides and 8 angles.
Oh, beep.
Yes, I used to keep a red octagon at the end of this stick, and it would help to stop people from crashing into me.
Oh, sounds like your octagon was a stop sign.
Maybe, because watch what happens when I don't have my octagon.
Please, I need an octagon.
Oh, this looks like a job for the Shapeabots.
Shapeabots, we go any place. Shapeabots, we can change our shape.
Stand back as I transform into an octagon. Transform! Octagon transformation complete.
Wait a minute. I don't think you are an octagon, because an octagon has 8 sides and 8 angles, and you only have 1, 2, 3 sides and 1, 2, 3 angles.
Oh, no! I transformed into a triangle again! B!
Maybe a triangle will work, though.
Look out! I'm right behind you!
I guess you can't use a triangle. Boop!
No, I really need that octagon.
Transform!
Let me try to transform.
Shapeobots, we go any place. Shapeobots, we can change our shape.
Transform! Transformation complete. Am I an octagon?
Well, let's see. Mm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 sides. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 angles. Yes, you are definitely an octagon. Come on. Whoa. You're a lot heavier than my last octagon.
Sorry. Beep, beep.
Hope this works.
Hey, that looks like a stop sign.
Yeah. Huh? It's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 sides.
That's the shape of an octagon!
Yeah, and stop signs are octagons!
We'd better stop and go a different way. Come on.
Yeah. Oh.
Beep, beep. It worked! Whoa!
Transform!
Oh, ow, you're transforming on top of my spleen! Are you okay? I'm fine. I'm great. I'm better than great. Having that octagon really came in handy. Thanks, guys.
All in a day's work for
Shapeobots, we go any place. Shapeobots, we can change our shape.
Hey, good job, Shapeobots. That was some awesome shape-shifting.
Thanks, Chris, but we are not done yet, Beep.
You're not? Well, you really think someone else is gonna need some shapes today?
Definitely. People need shapes all the time, Chris, Beep, Boop.
Help! Oh. I also need a shape.
See what Elmo Shapeobot means, Boop?
Don't you look like... Never mind, what shape do you need?
Well, as you can see by my baseball cap, I am a baseball coach. Mm-hmm. And we baseball coaches need pentagons.
Oh, a pentagon, beep.
Yes, a pentagon, beep.
He needs a pentagon, beep.
What's a pentagon, boop?
A pentagon is a shape with 5 sides and 5 angles.
That's correct. And for my players to score a run, they need to slide into a pentagon.
Oh, that's right, because in baseball, home plate shaped like a pentagon, right?
Yes, that's right. Because look what happens without it. Sorry, guys, you didn't score any runs. I'm not a pentagon. My team needs a pentagon!
Have no fear. This Shapeobot will now transform into a pentagon. Beep, boop, beep.
Shapeobots, we go any place. Shapeobots, we can change our shape.
Transform!
Pentagon transformation complete! Remember how I said a pentagon has 5 sides? Uh-huh. You just have 1, 2, 3 sides.
Oh! I am a triangle again! B!
Oh, no. Sorry, guys. Still no runs. My team really needs a pentagon.
Sorry, Boop. Transform!
Mini Elmo Shapeobot can transform into a pentagon?
Yeah, give it a try, buddy.
Right, Elmo is ready to transform.
Shapeobots, we go any place. Shapeobots, we can change our shape.
Transform! Transformation complete. Did Elmo Shapeobot transform into a pentagon?
Well, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 angles. Yes, you are definitely a pentagon.
Yay! Yay! Yay!
And just in time. Here we go. Yes! Yes! as Pentagon, you officially touched home plate and scored 3 runs! Thank you, Shapeobots. You guys truly are the greatest. Hey, wait up, guys!
No problem! Transform!
Anytime you need help with a shape, the Shapeobots will be here!
I need help with a shape.
Again? Come, just the same guy with the money. Forget it. What kind of shape could you possibly need now?
I need a rhombus.
Oh, a rhombus beep.
Yes, a rhombus beep.
He needs a rhombus beep.
What's the rhombus poop?
Oh, a rhombus. I know this one. It's a shape. It's kind of like a diamond.
Exactly. A rhombus is a diamond. You see, I have this friend. He's kind of a king. And he's missing his red rhombus, and he thinks it's my fault.
A king with a red rhombus?
Yes.
You wouldn't happen to be talking about the king of diamonds, would you?
Well, some people call him the king of diamonds, but I like to call him the king of rhombuses.
A rhombus! A rhombus, my kingdom for a rhombus.
Oh, there he is, darling. There is the chump who lost your rhombus.
It wasn't my fault.
All right, Ace. It's time you came face to face with the king of diamonds.
Gotta go.
What the juice? Come back here, you rhombus-robbing rapscallion.
I didn't take your rhombus.
Hey, aren't you guys gonna help me?
Elmo Shapeobot's not sure he can make a rhombus.
Oh, a little help!
Oh, you can't hide!
The King of Diamonds will flush you out!
No, oh, come on, how about you, Rosita?
I do not know. A rhombus sounds very hard.
I can really use a rhombus right now!
You're in trouble, mister. Trouble in space! I mean diamonds! Come back here, you...
I won't do it! I'll transform into a rhombus.
Hey, all right, Telly!
Have no fear, the Shapeobots are here. Beep.
Shapeobots, we go any place. Shapeobots, we can change our shape.
Transform. Oh no, I'm a triangle again. Beep! Transform!
Aha! Oh. It's time for some royal straight talk. Where's my rhombus?
I don't have it.
Wait! Come back here, you! Four flusher!
My heart! I mean, my diamond.
Oh, Telly, you gotta do something!
I can't! I'll never be able to transform into anything but a triangle.
Wait, Telly, look! Look at that diamond on the Queen of Diamonds!
Why are you looking at my royal rhombus?
Because a rhombus looks like it's two triangles stuck together.
Yeah, check it out. There goes one triangle, and there's another triangle.
So?
Well, so, if Telly can transform into one triangle, maybe he can transform into two triangles together.
Hey, yeah! Then I can be a rhombus!
Yeah!
Oh, hurry, Telly! I need that rhombus!
Oh. Enough talk! It's time to deal with the King of Diamonds!
Okay. But now, how do I make myself into another triangle?
Well, Telly, if you hit one button to become one triangle...
Maybe if I hit two buttons, I'll become a rhombus. Time to transform! Oh, no! I'm just a triangle.
Whoa! Oh, wow! It worked!
I'm in the shape of a diamond. I transformed into...
a rhombus! A rhombus suited for a king.
Oh, thank goodness.
Now I can be the king of diamonds again.
Hooray!
Come on, darling. Let's go tell Jack.
Oh, we want to hear this.
Oh, boy. It worked. Transform!
Thank you, Shapeobots. You guys really know how to get in shape.
No problem. All in a day's work for...
Shape-a-bots, we go any place. Shape-a-bots, we can change our shape.
Hey, guys, come on. Pizza's on me.
Thanks again.
My rhombus. What did you do with my rhombus?
Shape-a-bots, help!
Come back here, you joker!
Hi, I'm Johnny.
And I'm Abby.
And we're here to tell you about an amazing word.
A fantastic word!
Tell him what this astounding word is, Abby.
The word is transform.
Isn't that an awesome word? And you know what it means? The word transform means to change something into something else. Isn't that right, Abby?
That's right, Johnny.
And Abby Kadabby is going to transform something right now. Abby, what are you going to transform?
I am going to transform this pumpkin into a royal carriage.
So you're going to change the pumpkin into a carriage?
That's right.
This is so exciting. Okay, Abby, go ahead and transform the pumpkin.
Okay. Transform, transform, transform!
Abby, the pumpkin didn't change at all. It's still a pumpkin.
Yeah. Well, let me try again. Yep. Okay. Transform, transform, transform! Did the pumpkin transform at all?
No, it still hasn't changed at all.
Oh, boy. Maybe there's something wrong with my wand.
Here, let me see that.
Okay, but be careful, Johnny.
Don't worry, I'm awesome with wands.
Okay.
Transform, transform, transform. What happened?
Oh, Johnny, you transformed yourself into a pumpkin.
I did?
Yeah, but don't worry, I can change you back.
No, wait, don't.
Huh?
We wanted to show everyone transform, and I just transformed myself into a pumpkin.
Hey, yeah!
Transform. Okay, Abby, gotta roll.
Are you ready for some fairy fun? Great! Because Abby's flying fairy school is coming soon. But first, get on up and move your body, because it's time to freestyle with the letter Q. Move your body, move it all around. Now try and make the letter Q sound. Some words that begin with Q.
Quilt. Q.
Water.
Q.
Quarter. Not done yet. No time for rest. Think of Q words like quake or quest.
Queen.
Q.
Quiet.
Q.
Quit.
Q.
Queen.
Q.
We did a great job, but we're not through. Let's see more on the letter Q.
Quickly! She's coming to make a royal announcement! Quick! Quick! Queen Quagmire is approaching!
Quack! Quack!
Wyatt!
Quack!
Wyatt!
Quack!
Widget!
Quack!
Widget!
Quack!
Shh!
Quack!
Wyatt!
What's coming up next?
Abby's flying fairy school!
I can't wait!
Look, the pie in the sky, it is cool, it can fly.
Let's so hurry to the flying fairy school! Grab your wand! Bring your wings! We will learn magic things! Hurry to the flying fairy school! How to make us grow! And how to make us shrink! How to solve a problem with a single twinkle thing! This school is really magic! And magic is really cool! Let's go in! Let's begin! It's flying fairy school!
most restful time of the day. It's the time of day where every fairy takes a little nap and dreams a little dream. It's...
nap time!
You heard the clock, fairies! Everybody grab your mat and take a snooze. Looks like everyone's asleep.
Hi!
Maybe not everyone. What's wrong, Abby?
Oh, I'm having trouble falling asleep, Mrs. Sparklenose.
Well, you know what they say, Abby. When you can't get a wink of sleep, you'll nod off by counting sheep.
Oh, counting sheep. Got it. Okay, I'm gonna imagine some sheep so I can count them. Imagining sheep. Imagining sheep. This isn't working either. I can't imagine any sheep. Mrs. Sparklenose, I guess I better figure this out myself. Oh, I know! If I can't imagine sheep to count, maybe I can bring some real sheep. This'll work. Hurgle, Msnurgle, Gurgle, Mbeep. I wish I had some fairy sheep. Hello, sheep. I need to count you so I can fall asleep.
Count us? Oh, my stars, what an honor.
Oh, but we aren't even properly dressed.
Oh, how gosh. Let's find some chic new dad.
Hey, hold still so I can count you. One, two. Oh, dad. One, two. I don't know. Maybe we need more sheep.
Oh, good idea. Add some more.
Right. McGurgle, Magoo, McGargle, McGore. I wish we had seven sheep more.
Kick, kick, knee, kick, touch. Okay, everybody, kick line.
Oh, whoa, that's a lot of legs of lamb.
Yeah, isn't it great? Let's count the sheep and fall asleep.
One, two, three, four.
Sleep?
No, not yet. And neither is Peck. There's only one thing to do to get us all to sleep.
Yeah! Balance a pickle tub on my big toe!
I was going to say add more sheep to count.
Oh, that could work too.
Here goes. McGurgle, McGargle, let's add again. I wish for more sheep. Let's say 10.
Put 10. Hard.
What's going on?
We're counting sheep to get to sleep.
The ball's over here.
Get those sheep away from me.
As soon as we count, I'm gone again.
Well, hurry up and count.
Right, let's count sheep.
One.
Am I sleeping?
No!
Not of us are!
Looks like we can use a spot of help. Oh, Spot! Oh, Spot! Hiya, Spot. What can we do to fall asleep?
Three puppies in a basket. One is subtracted. That leaves one, two. Two puppies. Ooh. One more is subtracted, and that leaves one! One puppy.
What does subtraction have to do with getting to sleep?
I'm not sure. Let Twinkle think.
Twinkle think.
Oh, again!
The ball?
No. Maybe instead of counting sheep, we have to subtract sheep to fall asleep.
But how?
I have an idea. Blue 17.
Hey, well, the quarterback's calling a play. Get in formation.
Hut. Sheep and 10 went away. How many are left?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 sheep!
Woo! Looks like we need more subtraction.
I have an idea. Listen up, dancers! Follow me!
Oh, a new routine!
Okay! We had 10 sheep, and I got rid of 7 more. How many sheep are left?
Let's count.
1, 2, 3 sheep.
3 more to subtract.
Oh, I have an idea.
Is that what I think it is?
I'll run away.
That can only mean one thing.
Fashion show!
And as you know, in fashion, your eyes are in.
Or you're out!
Oh, it worked. We subtracted all the sheep.
But we're still awake.
Subtracting didn't put us to...
Nap time's over! Bring your mats to the cubbies!
You heard the clock, fairies! Time to wake up and...
Look at that! I guess the sheep worked after all. I suppose I can let my class sleep just a little longer. Happy nap time, fairies!
It's almost time for Super Grover! But first, we're gonna find out about...
The number 18!
How many is 18? 18 pairs! What are you doing?
The number 18.
Oh, can you count to 18?
2.0.
Oh, boy!
He observes.
Oh,
questions.
Hubba what?
He investigates.
What does this button do?
Super Grover 2.0. He shows up. In a world where love can be hard to find, some things can be even harder to find.
Darling, I love you. Will you make me happy as a clam and marry me?
Oh, my stars! Yes, yes, yes! Oh, no! Oh.
I'm all right.
Oh, where's my ring?
I don't know, honey. Did you see where it landed?
Oh, no. It's lost in the sand. How will we ever find it? Wait, do you hear that sound?
The heroic music.
No, the other sound, like a sick walrus.
Greetings, it is I, Super Grover 2.0.
We are so glad you showed up.
It is what they do. Now, how can I help?
Well, I've lost my engagement ring somewhere on this beach. Can you help us?
Have no fear. I shall unleash my powers of observation and have a look-see. Well, no wonder you cannot find your ring. This whole place is covered in sand.
Well, yes, it is a beach.
The ring is somewhere in the sand.
I shall once again unleash my powers of observation and get a closer look-see. Unleash! I shall pick up the sand and... Why is it so hard to pick up this sand?
Because sand is made up of many tiny pieces of rock or shell. It just falls through the spaces between your fingers.
So it does. But then how do you explain this?
That shell must have been in the sand. The little pieces of sand fell between your fingers, and the bigger shell got sifted out.
Hey, maybe that's how I can find my ring. We can use something to sift it out of the sand.
Yes, something with a hole in it so the sand will fall through, but the ring won't.
Stand back! I shall now unleash the power of technology! Let's see what tools I have in my utility sack. Aha! This should do the trick!
A bagel?
It does have a hole, but will it really work as a sifter?
Let us investigate and try to sift, sift, sift.
It's no good. The sand falls through, but so does everything else. Nothing got sifted out. The hole is too big.
Okay. I will just put it back in my sock then. Hey, my bagel! I was planning on eating that!
Oh, we're never going to find my ring!
Oh, there, my little starlet. We just need something with smaller holes.
I know just the thing.
Swiss cheese? This was in your sock?
I get very hungry on the job.
Well, Swiss cheese does have smaller holes, but will it make a good sifter?
Time to investigate and sift, sift, sift!
It's not working! The Swiss cheese doesn't have enough holes so the sand can't go through! That's not a good sifter after all!
Oh, well. I will just save it for snack time later. Hey, my cheese! The gall of that gall.
My ring is going to be lost forever!
Oh, don't worry, my shining star. All we really need is something with a lot of holes. A lot of tiny holes. Don't you have any tools like that in your sweat sock?
Utility sock. Let me check. All I have left in here is this spaghetti strainer.
Wait! That could work! It's got tiny holes and lots of them. This is just what we need to sift the tiny sand and find my ring. Start sifting!
All right, sift, sift, sift. But I do not think it will work. After all, this is meant for spaghetti. It is not going to help us find
it. Oh, it's my ring! Now we can get married.
Aw, congratulations! This calls for a celebration! I keep a cake in my other sock for special occasions just such as this. Oh, no, you don't.
And so, using his superpowers of observation and investigation, our hero found that a sifter is a tool that helps separate small and large pieces.
No! No! This is not for you! Not for you! No!
Oh boy! Elmo's world is almost here! But first, it's time to play Sounds of the Street! Come on, use your ears and listen for a sound. I hear something. Do you know that sound?
Saxophone!
Great! Let's do some more listening. Ooh, do you hear what I hear? What sound is that?
Drums!
Nice work! Whoa! That's a strange sound. What is making that sound?
A rooster playing a trumpet.
That was odd. Now, let's keep watching, because Elmo's world is coming soon.
Carolyn and Christopher like to eat a snack before they go out to play. Today, Christopher has a banana. Looks like Carolyn is eating cake. It's a good thing they had a little something to eat. It looks like they're planning to do some serious playing. What's wrong with Carolyn? She doesn't seem to have the energy to keep going. Christopher is still going strong. Why do you think she got tired so fast? She had cake. He had a banana. Maybe that cake wasn't the best thing to eat when she wanted energy that would last as long as she wanted to play. Hello again. It's another day. Looks like they both have bananas. Carolyn is going to have all the energy she needs. Yup. I do think that banana was a better thing for her to eat. Yup.
Hey guys, what's up next?
Elmo!
Oh yeah!
Mr. Noodle! Oh, well, Elmo
will use his mouth, to call Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle, where are you? Where is he? Mr. Noodle, where are you? Where is he? Mr. Noodle, Mr. Noodle, where are you? Mr. Noodle, you surprised Elmo. Mr. Noodle, Dorothy has a question. Are you ready? Good. How do you whistle with your mouth, Mr. Noodle?
Yeah, show us how.
No, that's not it, Mr. Noodle.
That's dancing, Mr. Noodle.
Nice footwork.
Yeah, but that's not whistling.
If you want to whistle, you have to blow.
You gotta blow.
Blow!
No, not like that.
He's blowing his nose. That's your nose.
Ew.
That's your nose.
Yeah. You have to use your mouth to whistle.
Your mouth, Mr. Noodle.
It's right under your... Yeah, that's your nose.
A little lower.
And that's your mustache.
Getting closer.
There, that's your mouth.
That's your mouth, Mr. Noodle.
Good job, Mr. Noodle. So take a deep breath.
Now blow.
Wait, what's he doing? Well,
don't give up, Mr. Noodle. Keep trying. First, he needs to wet his whistle.
Good idea.
You ready now, Mr. Noodle?
Whistle with your mouth.
Go for it. Yay!
Yay!
Mr. Noodle got it!
Good job, Mr. Noodle.
He whistles so loud, we call the taxi. Great whistling, Mr. Noodle.
Hey, you call a taxi? Well, hop in. But go up.
Go get him.
Bye, Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle. Okay, Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you whistle with your mouth?
Dorothy, this is how I whistle. I'm still learning to whistle, Dorothy. I can use my mouth to blow this.
Whistlers. Oh, and thank you, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. hello, baby. Hi. Baby, how do you whistle with your mouth? Oh, thank you, baby. Kiss, kiss. Mwah. Mwah. Baby. Oh, and now, Elmo will try whistling with his mouth. Like this. Elmo didn't hear a whistle, did you? Still no whistle, huh? Ooh, Mr. Noodle wet his whistle. Yeah, and he whistled. Okay. Oh, well. Elmo will try later. But now, Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many flies can this froggy catch with his mouth? Let's count them and see. Froggy, where are you? Oh, there you are. Aw, froggy. Oh, he's going to use his tongue. That's in his mouth.
Not that kind of mouth.
chicken's mouth is called the beak.
Does a birthday cake have a mouth?
No.
But you can use your mouth to blow the candles on the birthday cake. And eat it, too. Yum, yum. Does a plant have a mouth?
No.
Unless it's stinky.
You took the words right out of my mouth.
thank you, Drawer. And now, Emma will try to whistle again. Oh, come on, Math. You can do it.
Guess what? Me have mouth. Yeah. Ah, see, that me mouth. And the best thing that me do with mouth is sing light opera. Me. Just kidding. Ah, the best thing me do with me mouth is, come over here, eat cookies! Ah! Delicious! Me love me mouth!
Hey, that cookie monster sure said a mouthful! Thanks, computer! Boy. Elmo's friend Riley sings with his mouth, and he told Elmo all about it.
I go to singing class every week. When I sing, I use my voice and my mouth. First, we warm up with breathing exercises. And we stretch our mouth. We make a pumpkin face and a raisin face. And then we do voice exercises. A whole song.
Please sing, little kids and big kids too. Ta-da! Here we are, making our own way. We're about to make it big, cause we got a big smile. You're about to feel it big when we put a big smile on you and you and you and you.
Great and very useful.
Aw, thanks, Riley. Time to try whistling again. Maybe this time Elmo will do it. Okay. No whistling. Still no whistle. Whistling's hard. Elmo's feeling frustrated. Oh, thank you, Kiwi. That's nice. Elmo won't give up. Hey, maybe if Elmo knows more about mouths, it will help them whistle. Here, let's watch the Mouth Channel. Turn yourself on, Kiwi. And thanks again.
Welcome to the Mouth Channel. We're all mouth, and that says it all. And now, the boy who loved his mouth.
Once upon a time, there was a boy who loved his mouth.
I love my mouth.
He loved his mouth because he could use it for so many things. He used it to talk.
I love my mouth.
To laugh. And to yell. The boy used his mouth to eat, too. He used the teeth in his mouth to chew.
I'm a loud mouth.
And he used the tongue in his mouth to taste.
That tickles my taste buds.
The boy also used his mouth to show his feelings. When he was sad, his lips turned down.
I'm down in the mouth.
When he was happy, his lips turned up.
I love my mouth. Meow.
The boy loved his mouth so much he cleaned it every night.
And every morning, too. I brush my teeth and my tongue.
I love my mouth.
Then he used his mouth to kiss his cat goodnight.
Good night, Whiskers. Meow.
The boy loved his mouth so much, he even used it while he was sleeping.
The end.
Thanks, Stevie. Thanks again.
Wow, the boy was whistling in his sleep. Maybe Elmo can whistle in his sleep, too. But if Elmo's sleeping, how will he know if he's whistling? Wait a minute! Elmo's got it! Wait! If you hear Elmo whistle in his sleep, shout, Elmo! To wake him, okay? You got it? Good!
Want to talk to a guy with a mouth?
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's Elmo's good friend, Mr. Fred Newman. Hi, Mr. Fred Newman.
Hi, Elmo.
Oh. What's wrong? You need some help?
No, I got it.
Okay.
I heard you were thinking about mouths today.
What? How did Mr. Newman hear that?
Word of mouth.
What does Mr. Newman know about mouths?
Well, I know you can use your mouth to make all sorts of sounds.
Oh, like whistling.
Yep, like whistling. Or like,
That tickled. Wow, that was amazing.
No, I can show you how to do one. You want to learn to pop?
Yes.
Okay, and you can do this too. Make your mouth really round. Like this, and breathe through your nose. All right? Now take your hand flat and pop it on your mouth gently. You're breathing through your nose. Gotta pop. You try it. Yes, that's exactly right. That's exactly right.
Oh, you got your pop. Well, what other sounds can Mr. Newman make with his mouth?
Well, let's try, how about a monkey? Or an airplane.
Oh. Wow.
How about this one? You know what that is?
A fly with hiccups.
Bing, 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 bing. Yeah. That's right. You know, there are other things you can do with your mouth, too, like blowing bubbles.
Look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo blowing bubbles.
Blowing bubbles in a thought bubble. Cool.
Elmo's using his mouth to blow a bubble. Let's see if Elmo can make it bigger. Well, that's big. Let's see how Elmo can make it even bigger. Wow, bigger.
Some fish.
Yes, she is. Oh, Elmo loves mouths. Oh, and so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the mouth song with our mouth.
Mind if I sound along?
Sure.
Hey, pop along with us.
Sharing and caring every day.
You're getting smarter,
stronger.